Hey everyone, it's Justin again. In this lesson, we're going to be talking about simple probability. It's called simple probability just because it's the first building block that we can use to build towards being able to analyze more complex probability scenarios. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to calculate the simple probability of events. First, we'll discuss probability vocabulary and then discover a formula for simple probability. Then, we'll just complete two example problems. Before we talk about specifics, I want you to try to make a prediction. If you were to roll a regular die, the kind with six sides that are each labeled 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, what's the probability that you would get a number that is less than 3? We learned in our unit introduction that probability is always between 0 and 1, where 0 means it definitely will not happen, and 1 means that it definitely will happen. With this in mind, what do you think the probability is of rolling a number that's less than 3? The probability of rolling a number less than 3 is definitely not 0, because it totally can happen. For instance, I could roll a 2. And it's definitely not 1, because it might not happen. For instance, I could roll a 5. So it has to be somewhere in between, but where exactly? Well, if I perform this experiment, that is, roll the dice, what are the possibilities for what I can get? Yep, I can roll a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. Each of these possibilities is called an outcome, because it's something that can be a result of this experiment. This group of all of the possible outcomes is called the sample space. So I'm interested in the outcomes that are less than 3. How many outcomes meet the criteria of being less than 3? Just these, rolling a 1 or a 2. So there are 6 total outcomes, and 2 of them meet the criteria that I'm looking for. Does that help you narrow down what exactly the probability is? Well, if 2 out of the 6 outcomes meet the criteria, we could just turn this into the fraction of 2 over 6. As always with fractions, we should simplify this to 1/3. You could also convert it to the decimal of approximately 0.33, or the percent of approximately 33%, but I prefer to leave it as a fraction just so that I don't have to do any extra calculations. Let's recap and see if we can find a way to repeat this method to find the probability of other things. How did we go about figuring out that the probability of rolling a number less than 3 on a regular die is 1/3? Well, we started by determining how many total possible outcomes there are while rolling a die. That set of all the possible outcomes is called the sample space. Then we identified how many of those outcomes from the sample space met the criteria we were looking for. Lastly, we turned those two numbers into a fraction where we put the number of outcomes that meet the criteria on top and the total number of all possible outcomes on the bottom. This right here is the formula for simple probability. I want to point out that this is just one way to represent this formula. You might find this formula shortened in ways like desired over total, or even using symbols like a happy face for outcomes that meet the criteria and a T for the total. Make sure that however you write this in your notes is a way that will work best for you when you go back to reference it later. Let's put this new formula to the test with two more example problems. Our first example problem says that a bag of marbles contains 6 blue marbles, 3 red marbles, and 11 purple marbles. If I select a marble at random, what is... Oh, this is new notation for us. When you have capital P with something in parentheses next to it, it means the probability of that criteria. So part A is asking, what is the probability that the marble we pick is purple? And part B is asking, what is the probability that the marble is green? You can read them as P of purple and P of green. Let's start with part A, P of purple, or the probability that the marble is purple. If we think about that simple probability formula, where we can abbreviate probability as capital P, we need to figure out what is the sample space for this scenario. How many total possible outcomes are there for pulling a marble out of this bag? Do not fall into the trap here of thinking that, oh, because there are three colors of marbles, that there are three outcomes. There are actually 20 possible outcomes. That's because if I reach my hand into this bag, I could pick out any one of these three red marbles, six blue marbles, or 11 purple marbles, which makes 20 total possible marbles that I can randomly select. Counting each marble helps us account for the fact that the chances are not the same of selecting the three colors, since there are different numbers of each. If there are 20 total possible outcomes, how many of them meet the criteria of being purple? Yeah, there are 11 purple marbles, so 11 outcomes meet the criteria of being a purple marble. So here is our answer. The probability of selecting a purple marble at random is 11 out of 20, or 11 20ths. How about part B? What is P of green, or the probability of selecting a green marble? Well, since we're still dealing with this same scenario of pulling marbles from this bag, there are still 20 total possible outcomes. Out of those 20 total possible outcomes, how many of them meet the criteria of the marble being green? No. I know, this really isn't a typo, I promise. There are 0 green marbles in this bag, and that's okay. That just means that the probability of selecting a green marble is 0 out of 20, or 0, which makes sense. If I pull a marble from this bag, it will definitely not be green. Let's try one more example problem together. This problem says, Jack's closet contains 4 long-sleeved t-shirts, 5 long-sleeved button-ups, 8 short-sleeved t-shirts, and 4 long-sleeved Henleys. If he chooses a shirt at random, what is A, the probability that it is a long-sleeved, and B, the probability that it is not a t-shirt? Let's start with just part A. As a reminder, here is our simple probability formula. What do you think represents the number of total outcomes for this scenario? Since Jack is picking out a shirt, the total number of outcomes is just the total number of shirts. And for part A, what does the number of outcomes that meet the criteria mean? Our criteria is long-sleeved, so this is the number of shirts that are long-sleeved. Pause the video here and fill in the formula yourself. How many total shirts are there? 4 long-sleeved t-shirts, plus 5 long-sleeved button-ups, plus 8 short-sleeved t-shirts, plus 4 long-sleeved Henleys make 21 total shirts. So we can put 21 as the denominator. Of those 21 shirts, how many of them are long-sleeved? Well, there are 4 long-sleeved t-shirts, 5 long-sleeved button-ups, and also 4 long-sleeved Henleys. If we add all those up, that makes 13 total long-sleeved shirts. So the probability of Jack picking a long-sleeved shirt is 13 out of 21. Pause the video now and try part B out on your own. The total number of outcomes, or shirts, has not changed, so the denominator is still 21. The big question here is, how many of our outcomes meet the criteria of not being a t-shirt? Jack has 4 kinds of shirts. I only want to count the button-ups and the Henleys because they're not t-shirts. The other 2 kinds of shirts are t-shirts. So Between the 5 button-ups and the 4 Henleys, there are 9 total shirts that are not t-shirts. This gives us a probability of 9 over 21. And we can simplify this to 3 over 7, and that would be our final answer. In scenarios like this, where the outcomes can be categorized in different ways, like both by their shirt type and sleeve length, it's important to carefully consider each category to check if it meets the criteria or not. To calculate the simple probability of an event, first, determine how many total outcomes are in the sample space. Then, figure out how many of those outcomes meet the criteria that you're being asked about. Use those numbers to fill in the simple probability formula, and lastly, simplify the fraction if at all possible. As you work through your practice game, remember, probability will always be between 0 and 1. This is a great way to check that your answers are plausible. Good luck on that, and I'll see you next time.